Dear students, you are all welcome to the today's online class. Today, I am going to discuss with you the introduction to the 20th century English literature. Myself is K. Rangappugol. Dear students, you are all aware of the literature and literary period and literary centuries. So, in this we are studying the British literature in the 20th century. So, this is a brief introduction. In this class, I am going to discuss with you what is 20th century literature and what are the characteristics of this English literatures. So, this is a brief introduction of the 20th century English literature. So, 20th century is also called as the modern literature. As we know, that is a modern age is most advanced age of the previous one. So, the 20th century English literature is also called as the modern age of English literature. So, 1900 onwards, 1900 onwards, it is called as the 20th century English literature. So, 1901 to 1999 period. So, that period we are calling that is 20th century. So, the modern age in English literature was grounded in achievement that are amazing in their potential for both emancipation and destructions. So, this modern times achievements made that is emancipation and destruction in all the things they are the atomic energy, space exploration and genetic and biomedical engineering and telecommunication. These are all we can see in the modern age. The technological advances in this area could either save millions of human beings and the planet or destroy them. So this is a most advanced feature of the 20th century. So let's see what are the special characteristics of the present day tendencies in the life and letters. So that is a social life, letters means that is called as a literature. The first feature of the 20th century, that is anxiety and interrogation. So the 20th century is also called as the age of anxiety, means a lot of curiosity. So and the interrogation become the because the scientific revolution and the changing social, moral, political and economic conditions have shaken man's faith in the authority of religion and church. So and the established order. So these are all the changes happened, social, moral, political, economic changes in this age. So he does not accept anything unless it is tested on the touchstone of reason and computation. So in the modern man, he never accepted blindly. He want to test it, he want to read it, he want to understand it, then only the modern man will accept it. Moreover, the modern industrial and technical progress has given birth to the spirit of competition. So this is the technology was made, man will become the competitor for the everyone. Everybody wants to come out successful in the rat race, but only a few are crowned with laurels. This failure coupled with the complexities of modern life has resulted in the frustration, anxiety and cynicism. So in a race, a man can only one man can occupy in one place. So this is competition made man frustration or anxiety in his life. So the anxiety and interrogation, that is a question mark. So that is a main feature of the 20th century. So how man become literate, he will become more questionable man. So he, without question, he will not accept anything. Next, art for life's sake. So the 20th century is people are art for life's sake. So earlier art for art's sake. The art, the turn of the new century came a number of writers who were skeptical in outlook and were not touched by reverence of for custom and the established order 20th century. Writers rejected the doctrine of art for art's sake. So these 20th century people or writer, they never accept the art for art's sake. See, they want to enjoy their life. So they are telling art for only life's sake, not for art's sake. They established the new literary creed of art for life's sake, or at least for the sake of community. For example, the D.H. Lawrence finds out art for my sake. So the modern people are more educated and they are more civilized people. They are self-centered people. In the last decade of the 19th century, a much stronger claim to be modern was made by Shaw with his, that is G.B. Shaw with his socialism, H.J. Wells with his science fiction, and Rudyard Kipling with his empire building and steam engines. The change of outlook in the beginning of the 20th century was due to the growth of restless desire to prove and question. So this is the outlook of the 20th century. G.B. Shaw so vigorously attacks the old superstitions of religion, superstitions of religion and a new superstitions of science. So he attacks on the science. The effect of his writings was to spread for at least a generation the interrogation habit of mind. So this is art for art's sake. The next feature of the 20th century, that is growing interest in the poor and the working class. So that is main feature. The 20th century writers took interest in poor and working class. So this is the main focusable point in the 20th century. The earlier literary works focus only Pope, Church, royal class. So this is the first time these people are focusing on the working class and the poor class. They have taken a great interest to improve the living conditions of the poor working class through their writing. So the poor people also writing in this century. The poor were no more helpless creatures. They had grown conscious of their sad predicament. They posed a great challenges to the social conscience. So the poor class people also got more interest to write in this age. Poor and the working class people become the raw material for the realistic, moral and dramatic with or without purpose. So the poorness of the people or working class people hardship will be the material for their writing. Mid-Victorian writers Dickinson, Thackeray, Kingsley, Reed and Mrs. Gaskell, etc. These are the examples of the working class writer have given injustice to the poor and working class people, but justice given by the 20th century writers Shaw, Galsworthy and H.J. Wells. So these are writing for the poor and working class. These Dickinson, Thackeray, Kings, they give less importance to the working and poor class. Next feature of the 20th century, that is the impact of socio-economic condition on literature. The literature of 20th century has been greatly influenced by economic and social changes. So the growth of the civilization, the growth of the knowledge of the people, they are more developed in economy and social changes. That is, social changes means they are more civilized than the earlier. The industrial expansion has grown up rapidly after the 19th century. So in the 18th and 19th, the industrial revolution started in England, but it took highest peak in the 20th century. The landed aristocracy and agricultural laborer were in the great trouble. Young villagers began to migrate to industrial town, and there was complete breakup rural way of life. You might have real the deserted village by William Goldsmith. So after the revolution of industrialization in the England, the people of poorer class, they are migrate toward the town for sake of money. For example, we can see in the Goldsmith deserted village. In the new century, emphasis was put on urbanization, which completely changed the pattern of social relationship. Money became the key factor of in all the human relationship. I told already. So the 20th century is people more civilized and they are more developed in the name of economy. So though money is the matter for everything. The new economic theories of economics like Marshall and Keynes, who raised their voice against poverty and changed the pattern of social behavior, influenced literature. So they all comes in the 20th century. Literature become urban. Marxism was the most powerful influence. So when this industrialized developed, so the writers are giving more importance to the working and labor class. So the poor is the main theme of the all the things. So Marxism is the main powerful influential term in the 20th century. The next feature of the 20th century, that is psychology and literature. So the new psychological researches influenced literature of the 20th century. So when the people are more civilized, when they are more developed in economically, they are more dealt with the researches. Sigmund Freud put a great emphasis on the power of the unconscious to affect conduct. Unconscious element in the mind which influence consciousness, and the importance of the child semi-consciousness of sex as the factor in the mental development. So that is, people are more developed in all the things. They are more literate people. They are searching for the unwanted things. So then Sigmund Freud make conscious and unconscious things. These are the psychological researches happened in the 20th century. So the factor we can see, the sex is the most repeated word in the 20th century. The two world war virtually brushed aside all the familiar notions of conduct and morality. Sex was considered to be the amoral. So it is after the First World War and Second World War, it impact on the human mind. So Bertrand Russell said, sex is a natural human need like a food and drink. So what we thinking in India, so it is as a vulgar thing. So if you are thinking in the foreign, so it is as an activity of the people. So it is a need of the human thing, how we have a food and drink. So love should be the tree whose roots are deep in the earth, but whose branches extended in chain. So that is called love, in the manner of Bertrand Russell. The new theories of psychology and sex gave us the Stream of Consciousness novel by D.H. Lawrence, Virginia Woolf, and many other were influenced by the new researches in the psychology and sex. So in the name of the research, we can find out so many theories in the 20th century. That is a Stream of Consciousness novel. So Stream of Consciousness novel, it is nothing but how our mind is thinking, where our mind is going. That is a stream like a river. How river is flowing, our mind is also flowing. That is Stream of Consciousness novel technique. So that is main thing in the 20th century novel. Next, the impact of the two world wars. So I told in the already, the First World War 1914 to 18, and the second one is 39 to 45. It is mostly effect and impact on the people. The period was completely overshadowed by the two world wars. So this is the 20th century is shadowed by the 20th two world wars, that is First World War and the Second World War. The first war period was an era of depression and the want and unemployment. So what happened during the First World War? So that is depression in the all the people's mind, and they want of everything, and there are a lot of unemployment happened. After the Holocaust of the First World War, League of Nations established. An international organization was set up with a view of establishing world peace. So after the First World War, there is a League of Nations established for the world peace. But the ideas behind the organization could not materialize. The Second World War happened 1939-45, broke out and was far more catastrophic than the First World War. So it is a very destructive World War after the First World War. By the end of the war in the September 1945, the England has suffered not only the loss of hundreds of thousands of young men, but the devastation of the wide area in London. Sir Winston Churchill described the Great War and its effect on London in 6 volumes of the Second World War. So many writers written the effect of the Second World War in England. So Richard Aldington, The Death of a Hero, 1929. Edmund Blunden, Undertones of War, 1928. Wilfred Owen and Sassoon exposes the futility, hollowness. So another thing we have to remember, in the 20th century we will see the development of literature, that is war poetry and stream of conscious technique. So many literary genre developed. Next, the influence of radio, cinema and television. So the 20th century is most developed period in the literature. The development of radio, cinema and the television had an enormous impact on literature. In so far as the radio brought literature into the home in the form of broadcast stories, plays and literary discussions, etc. So writers are writing the stories, but for illiterate or literate people, those who don't have time to spend with books, so they are listening stories by the broadcast, by the radio. Coexistence of isms. So there are a lot of coexistence of isms, means there are a lot of isms are developed or theories are developed. For example, classicism, romanticism, realism. So what is a classicism? A way of living, writing by a set of rules and regulations, putting the words into high order. So that is a classicism, means that is the highest peak of literature. So that is the greatness of literature. Romanticism, breaking the rules of the classicism and following imagination and the emotion, which we consider bedrocks of romanticism. So classicism is a set of rules, romanticism is a break up the rules. Whatever you feel, you have to feel in the literature. Then realism, far away from the romanticism and classicism, can't go together. So this realism will can't go to the set up rules and unset up rules. It has its own formation. Next, coexistence of forms. Forms, drama and poetry, Eliot, Shaw, rebirth of drama, drama Eliot, its poetry, coexistence of two forms, drama and poetry, and its founded, that is Irish literary movement, that is Irish poetry developed together and become so popular in the 20th century. So G.B. Shaw is developed and he give the rebirth of the drama, and W.B. Yeats give the rebirth to the poetry in the 20th century. In the all this development happened. Obscurity. What is the darkness hidden in the 20th century? Obscurity is the most important feature of the modern age. Obscurity means complexity. So when people have more knowledge, he will have complex what to do and what not to do. Difficult to understand by society, people. T.S. Eliot's The Wasteland. The sense of complexity we can see in the wasteland. Emotions and experiences are very complex in the 20th century. So there are a lot of experiences happened to the every man. So there is a lot of difficulties and a lot of confusions happened in the 20th century. Next, the city consciousness. 20th century literature, city consciousness developed more, and there are a lot of alienation, loneliness, loss of communications, loss of sense of love and lack of fraternity. So when this industrial developed, when people are migrating towards the city and there is no relationship, they only want money to live. So the money is for every relation, they think that they lost. And when they migrated toward the city life, they are alienated. There is no group. They all are the single man. They want only single. Then only they will happy. There is no togetherness. Then the spread of education. During the 20th century, there has been a rapid progress of education. So there are a lot of educational institutions developed in this century. The ladder of educational opportunities for elementary school to university was now available to the poorest boy who had the ability to take advantage of educational facilities are available to all the classes of people. So the earlier age, we can see only Pope and the kings and aristocrat people and rich people have only have availability of the schools. Then this 20th century made education will become the available for the poor people also. Literacy has gone up. The rapid progress of education has brought about enormous output of books, and a lot of people are going to read the books. Even though poor also got education, then only they started reading. Next, the dominance of the novel. So 20th century is named famous for the novels. In the modern literature, the novel has become the dominant literary form. In addition, the novel is admirably suited as vehicle for the sociological studies, which attracted most of the great artists of the period. So this is a vehicle to reach all the people. The modern novelist is not only interested in social problems, but also equally well inclined to discuss psychological problems of the modern age. The great novelists are Thomas Hardy, Thomas Henry James, Joseph Conrad, H.G. Wells, D.H. Lawrence. These are all people focus on all the elements of the human. Next, the feature of the 20th century is experimentalism. The new experiments were tried in all the branches of literature. They are the 20th century people or the writers are very research minded. The traditional forms were thrown out, and in the place new literary experiments were made in the field of poetry, drama and novel. Working class drama, Eliot's poetry, problem play, stream of conscious novel. These are all the new experiments in the fields of drama, poetry and novel. So these are all the developed forms in the 20th century. Next feature, the foreign influence on the 20th century English literature. So the 20th century English literature has considerably been influenced by the foreign artistic in the field of drama, poetry and fiction. Ibsen's influence on the modern drama has been profound in the sphere of forms, matter and stage craft. So before, the England people are focusing on only England, then the English literature is only dealt with or bond with or attached with only England people. Then when this globalization started in the modern age, that is, the English literature is spread its areas, then the all other countries' peoples, for example, India, Africa, South Africa, Australia, other than the British, they are started and they are writing their themes into the English, and they are contributing to the development of English literature. So that happened in the foreign influence. Ronald Dostoevsky, Flaubert's influence the clearly perceptible in the modern novel. The philosophical theories of Henry Bergson and Sigmund Freud here colored the fiction of James Joyce, Virginia Woolf and Charles Morgan. So these are all have contributed for the development of English literature in the 20th century. The age of realism. This is the most important character in the 20th century novel. The literature and the life of the modern age are governed more by realism than romance and romanticism. The present age is essentially the age of realism. So this 20th century give more focus on the reality, not imagination, not fixed set of rules. These people, they never set up rules nor imagination. The 20th century writers do not deal with the times of King Arthur and the Middle Ages. They have concentrated their attention on the problems of modern life, and discoveries have brought a transformation in the old romantic values of life. They have given a materialistic twist to whatever is considered scarce and valuable life. Next, the age of disturbance. So this modern age is considered age of disturbance, darling. So this 20th century is also called as the age of disturbance. So the lot of disturbance happened in the age, that is religiously and socially, economically, and in a relation. So all the things have disturbed in the 20th century. That's why this age is called as the age of. Dear students, now I discussed all the characters of the 20th century. So this is a conclusion for the 20th century literature. The Victorian era closes in 1900. Actually, it came to an end during the 80s. The last 10 years of the century saw a ferment of new ideas, gave birth to fresh set of forces in literary life, and witnessed a reaction against many of the old Victorian ideas. So this is the end of the Victorian time or Victorian age. This is the started of the 20th century. The dawn of the 20th century witnessed the emergence of new values in the fields of social, political, economical, and literary life. Compton Rickett points out three points, features of new age: its reiteration, repeat again and again, of the old revolutionary formula of liberty, equality, and fraternity in new settings. And this, it happened in the 20th century. The second one, it is a worship of power rather than beauty. So there is a lot of power in the 20th century. It's challenging attitude of the elder values of art and life. So this is the most important one. In the 20th century, the transition of the old to the new, from build faith to rational thinking, is very interesting. So these are the conclusion part of the 20th century. So 20th century literature is most developed and advanced thing. So whatever earlier we had, so that happened in the this age. So I hope you understood the brief introduction of the 20th century English literature. So students, if you have any questions, you can ask the questions in the comment box. Thank you, everyone.